I sound like a dinosaur. So... Sorry. The garlic is going in the butter. Chewbacca! Wait. I like, but it's like the same design in the glass. Oh, you want, okay. Okay. You can pick whatever matcha glass you want, man. But then you're gonna pay for it, that's true. You should have asked that for Christmas, you know? You know? And then rosemary, thyme, and parsley. So, I froze fresh rosemary for the first time and it discolored a little bit, but the smell is still super fresh. So I'm thinking about just going with it. And it will be fine.
Cookie.
Hi, Cookie. Hi, friend. I asked for a book for uni. Uni books are very important. Very important and expensive. Good choice. Sound like an anti-aircraft Gatling. A barista kit. A fake fire in the oven. You like it? I bought a barista kit for a friend for $2.50. What was in that kit? I think you overpaid maybe a little bit. Hi, new Foxman, everyone. Chat, this is Foxman. He is new. Foxman, this is everyone. Parsley, sage. Is that a song? I don't know if you can freeze it. That's why I tried it. And I think it worked. Can you freeze potatoes? You can freeze potatoes, Sahi, but you have to process them first. You have to boil them first or fry them first, and then you can freeze them. Otherwise, I don't think it will be good. Are we making soup? I got plenty of time. Time is on my side. Okay. Hi, new. I'm very kind of you. Oh, see, majority of chat likes coffee with milk. Tesco's had an offer on roast veggies, so I bought the carrot and going to chop it up tomorrow to freeze, but the potatoes was only in 2 kilogram bags. Boof. Everyone should have a fake fire and fake snow in their kitchen. Just saying. Just saying. You're gonna do a real fire. I could just chop carrots and freeze those. Yes. You can. Did you vote for my new nickname? Is it on a... No? Wait, guys. This is very important. Latest. Wait, where do I vote for the nickname? I don't see it. Oh. Oh, it's on your Twitter. Oh boy. Everyone go vote on a new nickname. Okay. New nickname. Latest Slay Queen. It's maybe, it's a nice name, but it's too long. So... everyone calls you latest, but I feel like it shouldn't be your new nickname. It needs to have a new thingy. I'm latest C. I think I'm gonna go for I'm latest C. Oh, cock. I have to log in. Latest C. Everyone says latest. Just everyone, like, I like saying latest, but I don't feel like it should be your whole name. You know, it's like my name is Clara Coffee, but everyone calls me Clara. You know? Claret. Oh yeah, or claret. There you go. Going to snip snip. Arthur two sheds. What? Everyone is agreeing to latest. Because I refuse to be called victim. Late. Just call it late. I just fully registered latest name on Twitch. Wait, what? As the old dumb but highly accurate joke goes, call me anything. Just not late for dinner. I actually never heard that joke before. My latest victim was your mom. Oh my god. Can I give you a hug? Sure. Hugs are nice. We like hugs. I don't know a person who doesn't like hugs. Can I join in the hug? No. No naughty hugs, okay? Get some time. They're both chilling. One in the sofa and one on the beanbag. Not with books, thank you. Just, you know, pepper and salt. So we're making the butter, which we're going to put on the chicken. And then we're gonna get all the other stuff ready. Butter needs to be a bit softer. Then we need one onion and more spices. Where is my and one lemon? Where is my onion? Oh, it was right here. I know someone who doesn't like hugs. The one in the bid. Need to give Kitty Cat eye drops and he really doesn't like it. Oh, the baby! Poor, poor Urbanus. The poor cat. But he has no choice, Peter. It has to be done. Okay. Now this is some good herby butter. That is that. Now, the lemon and the onion. Me. You don't like hugs? Liar. But no, for it's a serious question. Are there people who don't like hugs? And what is your reason? Is it because like you don't like the contact? Or is it because you got scared after like the whole COVID situation? Or what is it? Because me myself, I'm a hugger. I really like to give hugs. And Michelle, she doesn't really like to give hugs. But she tolerates it when I give her a hug. I think my sister also doesn't really like to give hugs, but my brother, he does like to give hugs. My dad is not a hugger. My mom is a hugger. Oh, there you go, UXO. That's okay. I can maybe understand. Maybe. How are you not crying? Because I'm a pro. I'm a pro onion cutter. It doesn't do me nothing. Actually, it's really crazy because normally it does make me cry a lot. I think it depends on the onion and on how sharp your knife is, maybe. I think the more liquid is in your onion, or the older your onion is, the more likely. I'm a rock. I'm tough. The older your onion is, the more likely it is that you will cry. I'm gonna wash the lemon, because we're also going to pop in a lemon. Gonna quarter it. So we have our lemon, our onion, our butter, our chicken in an oven dish. Should do a crying stream where you cut onions the whole time. You want to see me cry? Garlic naan? I do like garlic naan though. Just want a man I can live inside in. Wait. What did Sahi say? I just want a man I can live inside in and just never let go. Why do you want to live inside a man? Spin the hot pepper wheel and you hear her sniff half an hour. Ella. Lego Ship says, I spent most of my life hating human contact. I think it was like a pet peeve where it just made me upset. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. I will never hug you. I promise. Even though I'm a hugger, I will not touch you. I'm a hugger, I mean not right now unless someone watched to catch Mike. Being a big guy, I like to crush my victims with lots of love and hugs. Yes! You have to kill them! Kill them with kindness! I am a robot? Yeah. A robot that likes hugs. Me and a mansion. This is the last Christmas you guys will have at your old place. It's true. I can't, it's like, it's a bit surreal still. Like, is this happening? It's crazy. But it's happening. So, the first week of January will be my last week streaming cooking in this apartment, in this kitchen. And then the weeks following in January will be streams of us working in the house, painting, doing that, and then the setting up all the stream gear. And I'm really looking forward to it. It's going to be hectic, but it's gonna be amazing. Here's my chicken. What shall we call it? Like how, you know, those hugs where you just lay on top of them and just fall asleep and they wrap you up. Oh. Oh, you love hugs now? Yay. Okay, guys, we can hug him. We can hug Legoshi. Sleep cuddles get too hot? Nah. Do they? Nah. Oh, yep, we got a house. We bought a house, you exo guy. We're moving. We're moving sick on a 6-minute drive away from this apartment. I know, it's crazy. So I had to make it weird. Okay. Hi, Lara. Are you ready for your family Christmas party stream tomorrow? I reset my brain today. I think I know you. Hey, I'm new. Hey guys, my name's Clara. I'm new. I love chick, but we're not gonna marry. Short moves are the best. Yes. I'm Gak. Oh, you're also making chicken? How are we gonna call the chicken, guys? What shall we name her? Shall we name her? It needs to be Joseph. Or baby, sweet baby Jesus.
Latest CHICKIA.
Yay, we're gonna call the chicken latest. The latest chicken. Now she's a cool chick, man. Okay, I'm going to poop. Leave the cord on. Food in 5 minutes. Oh, is it already been 30 minutes? I've got some of the ingredients I need to make sure I remember them. Oh, I'm so looking forward to soon. Now I'm gonna call latest the chicken. And she will never know why. I think she's AFK for a bit. That's okay. Tuck the chicken wings underneath the breast. Stuff the chicken cavity with the rosemary and thyme. And thyme springs. Voila. And lemon too, I suppose. So we're gonna pop it off. Pop it in. In you go. Oh. If you go, never go chopping hungry. Onion is going in. This is all for the flavor of the chicken, by the way. Lemon. Okay. Now, we're going to put the butter under the skin. If you cannot see this, I'm sorry. Look away. It's getting down to 10 degrees. Minus 12? Are you going to have a white Christmas then, Cookie? Because that would be cool. Does anyone know why you have to put the butter under the skin? Oh, I was... Sorry, latest, I was a bit rough with the butter. And now we're gonna spread it over, make like a herby butter crust, like we did with the turkey on Thanksgiving. And also on the thighs. Nice! Thank you for the bit. For the chicken wing. Cookie, what are you having for Christmas dinner? I don't know if I already asked, but I'm asking again. This will give the crust and the chicken and the sauce a lovely flavor. And color. I'm also going to spread it on the thighs. It's a dirty, dirty step, but it will be worth it, guys. Trust me. Voila. There you go. Latest is fully buttered and ready to go.
Oh yes, oh yes, I never felt so buttered before. Mmm, butter.
You're so slippery. I always watch Clara, no worry, I'm always, no wonder I'm always hungry. I fib! Hello, Charles. Maybe you should cook yourself an amazing dinner as well, geeky. Bone-in prime rib roast, scalloped potatoes and creamed spinach. I mean, I would be down for a prime rib roast for Christmas. So normally I had another dish to make for Christmas stream, but I forgot and it's now still in my freezer. And I'm going to make it on New Year's Eve. Butter on my thighs, yes. Yorkshire pudding. What is Yorkshire pudding? Why do restaurants not just deliver Sunday roast? Aren't you cooking a CGI? What is a CGI chicken? What is that? Real butter cake. I feel so smooth and delicious and herby. I would cook more if I had people to feed. Yes. I think I can understand that. Okay, let's go. Hey Google, set timer for 1 hour and 20 minutes called chicken. Will the chicken be stuffed? Well, you do have some lemon, onion, rosemary and thyme stuffed up. So, it's gonna be, of course it's an oven. It's a, look, it's like, it's my oven. Hi, Hellfire Acid Face. Cheers with coffee with milk. I'm so happy that people are falling for my fireplace. I love it. I was actually considering to not do it, but then I was like, heck it. I wanna have a fireplace on my stream. And then you guys are all falling for it. So I'm a happy girl. I'm a happy girl. It's been a while since... Corner time. Latest? Corner time. Hi Elios. Merry Thursday before Christmas Eve. Yay! How are you doing? Happy Twitchmas. Not falling for your fireplace would be the puts. Nice. Dinner is here. Bon appetit, Pierre. God damn it. Very much a day. You're a girl? Me? What? No. What are you talking about? Who is a girl here? I don't know. What? Prep chicken, prep potatoes. Uh-huh. Sorry, I'm new. You're new again. Oh, did you go for the chicken sliders or the pork sliders? What are those things on top? What are these balls? Ooh, pork. Nice. Good choice. Good choice. Looking good. Very good. Chili cheese. I love balls. Okay. Guys, Pierre loves balls. Let's, okay. Last stream until the 28th. Yes. Yup. So this is my Christmas stream. She's a pretty fun, nice, and adorable girl. I'm so adorbs. See ya, bye, Foxman. Until you're new here again. Bye-bye. Okay, I washed the potatoes. So I know that the potato stacks are actually so 2021. But I still wanted to make them because they look super nice and they are easy to... I am a coffee bean. What kind of bean are you? Are you a... I don't know. Another bean? Oh my gosh, so outdated. I know, right? Now I want whiskey. Shall I get a whiskey? Juan. Potato steak? I'm gonna make potato steaks. I'm gonna make potato steaks. Why, thank you. Oh, yeah. Me too. But for me, it don't matter because I have tomorrow off, so it's basically weekend-ish for me too. Potato stacks. It's a stack of potatoes. Yes. So you slice your potatoes in your mandolin and then you put them in butter and then you add cheese and herbs. And then you put them in the oven. Yeah, it's like a gratin, but without the cream. So now I'm going to pop them in the water. Another option. Ooh, did I get you that one?
No.
Ah, where did you find it?
Where
did you go? Wow. Guys, look. It's crazy green kiwi lemonade. Ooh, duck fat, max pack. Good idea. I think it will give you lots of flavor. Which one? Oh, you're eating the t-shirt. Nice. That's good. You can take it. Just not the very ugly one, because that needs to go to Hellfire Recipe.
I'll lick it.
Wait, do you have a job? Yes. I need a job. It's a cool... You can type exclamation mark steal. I have up until the end of the year. Technically, I have 2.5 hours of work left. But no one else is working today. You're gonna have the full 1.5 week off. This is very good.
I'm not stealing.
Yes, you can get out of the corner because you told on Vincent. That's good. It's fresh. Scalloped. We call what you're making scalloped potatoes. The potato stack. That's a very fancy name for a potato stack.
Oh, that's all right, little Hank. It doesn't matter if you have the beard on the outside, as long as you got the beard on the inside.
Hey, Lara, Pierre.
So we're rewarded for being tattletales here? Yes. And if you wash them in the water, you wash the starch off and you will get crispier potatoes. And this is also a very good way of seeing how much you need if you're going to make just a dinner for the two of you or the one of you. It's a lot easier to portion out. Ooh, Ooh, fries. Fries are good. I'm tired enough, I might even be convinced to drink coffee today, sir. Who is a sir? Me? I need to invest in a mandolin. I keep calling this a Mandalorian. It's so stupid. I keep getting it wrong, but it's very nice. If you don't cut your fingers. To know what to have for dinner. Soup and toast. Can you make like a cheese toast? So I'm going to wash those, get a towel. So I can dry them and then pop them in the other bowl. Which we're going to add the rosemary, parsley, rosemary and parsley. If I was smarter, then I could have used the same bowl as the butter for the chicken, but it's already watered down. I keep seeing Nando's. What are Nando's? You'll have to be wrapped in butter. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm too innocent for all of this. Still confused how the name was chosen. I think he was still thinking about what name to give you. And then I wanted the name for the chicken. And he said, latest. I think that. Nando's is also a very nice chicken name, to be honest. I'm cheesy. The fanciest name for potato stacks that I've seen is milfie potatoes. Can we call them milfie potatoes? Okay. That is that. We need butter. No? More butter? Melted butter, so I'm going to get all the butter that's still on here. No butter will go to waste. We need about a little bit more. For 1 kilo of butter, 1 kilo of potato, you need 2 tablespoons of butter. Oh. Another dad joke? Oh, I missed it. Wait, why do you have to go back to the corner? Because you're a chicken? Wait. I'm used to calling him Sir from a channel. Oh, you're talking about Pierre. Is it a fast food place? Oh. Nando's is a fast casual restaurant that serves piri piri chicken. okay. Another missed chance for Belgium. I see. I'm going to melt this. The chicken is doing fine. I have the herbs here. Rosemary. Mm-hmm. So I always snip it up in a glass with kitchen scissors. I just discovered the cute Baby Yoda. Do you see that it also is wearing a Christmas hat? I love him. Have you heard the rumor going around about butter? Never mind. I should not spread it. Love it. Love it. Very good dad joke. I give that one an 8 out of 10. Ooh, mashed potatoes are nice. We are getting another snow. Oh, I guess Hellfire Acid Face is going for a white Christmas. I'm sorry to hear that, friend. That doesn't sound like a lot of fun. The mash or fries? I think if I had to choose, if I got to choose, I would go for the fries because fries are top tier. Ooh, Nando's French fries. I'll take it. Let's see. Olive oil. There. Salt. Okay, I'm going to use the lava salt. So we have, oh my god. We have the pepper and the lava salt. This is black. It's salt from Iceland. It's nice. It's gonna give the potatoes a cool extra dimension. More or less like a smoky salt. Okay, potatoes. I'm gonna dab them dry. It's lava salt. Yes! Thank you for the potato song. Hi, Breaking Build. Hello. Hi, K.O. Happy holidays to you too from the party animal. You're a party animal. How are you doing? How is the cookie business going? Bit goal on Vincent's OnlyFans by Iceland.
By Iceland?
Well, yeah, I don't know.
Hey Google, sing a song.
Yeah, shall we do a Christmas song? Okay, we can vote on a Christmas song. First, I need some ideas. On the Christmas song. What do we want? No, it didn't work. Google did not recognize the voice or. It needs to be a Christmas song. Ah. Pax Givel. Lang geleden voor de allereerste keer. Je had te moeten zien. Het was verschrikkelijk slecht weer. Jezus is geboren. Halleluja. Hallo. Jezus is geboren in een bakje vol met stro. Ping ping. Dat doe je niet goed. If I can sing the song. We also had Holly Jolly Christmas.
Okay.
Anyone else want to share a good Christmas song that we can sing together? Sleigh ride. I'm better on a sleigh ride together with you. How does it go again? Giddy up, Rudolph. Maybe. Oh, the mistletoe. Is that the Justin Bieber mistletoe? Okay. Do they know it's Christmas dinner? Let me first make my potato stacks. So I mix it in the olive oil and butter and herbs, pepper and salt. Yo, yo, yo! Pantera. Thank you so much for the raid! Hello, 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 Purple Coffins and the her lovely people. Welcome, welcome, thank you so much for the raid. How are you doing? Salut, comment ça va ce soir? Salut, Crash and Burn, comment ça va? Joyeux Noël? Joyeux presque Noël? We're here for Christmas dinner! So, we're having Christmas dinner on a budget. First of all, you're all party animals. We're having chicken. It's roasting right there. I can show you. The chicken's name is Latest. We have Baby Yoda with a Christmas hat. There is the chicken. We're going to make potato stacks. We're going to make frozen beans wrapped in bacon. We're going to make baked apple and cranberry, and we're going to make a tomato and mozzarella candy cane. Oh, mince pies. It's the latest chicken. Chicken. How was your stream? Hi, Flings the Jinx. Welcome in. Hope you're doing well. Actually, I'm thinking it's not going to fit. So we're just going to make the stacks without the cupcake. Because you don't really need that. It was just, I guess, easy, but we're just going to make the stacks on the baking paper. Did you make the mince pie filling yourself as well? Can we visit Switzerland in April? I want to go to CERN and get a standard model shirt. A what? Standard from the coffee magazine or standard like a standard? It was good, my last one for the year. My, that's crazy. Hey, good work. Very well done. Take your rest now. Do you have cool plans for the new year? Except for the thing I couldn't make because I forgot Peter. Those are the struggles. The struggles of food and drink streamers. Multiple visits to the supermarket. Very sad, but that's our life. So I'm just pressing the potato slices together. And the butter and oil will make it stick. And then when I find any smaller slices, I will just put them on top so that you get like a nice stack thingy. a different... What kind of potato stack did you think I was going to make? These are potato stacks, right? Rexy! Hello, my friend. Ooh, the unexplained. All right. Does anyone want a holiday tarot reading, by the way? I actually want to know what my tarot reading is for the holidays. So I am going to read mine for sure. Sure. T-shirt with the quantum physics standard model equation. They don't have an online shop. You have to go. Oh my god. Oh no. That is a very important reason why you would want to go to Switzerland. I totally understand it now. It's like a bucket list item. I understand. Voila! These are my potato stacks. What do you think? Ta-ta! Bob, I'm tired and hurting. Ready for the holiday to be over with. Didn't even start yet. Rexy, what did you do? What did you do that you're already hurt? I feel like every single photo I've seen of Switzerland is beautiful. Switzerland is very beautiful. By the way, aw, that's so kind. Yes, people. I feel like here. If you like what you see, don't forget to follow all of my socials. I also have a TikTok channel where I make beautiful food videos. If you want to learn how to cook, check out my Instagram Reels and my TikTok. There. Lamb korma? Mmm. Nice. How terrific! Where is he? Hi, Karmic Bob! Yes, can we all give Rexy a hug now? Ooh, nice. Peace kiss. Okay. I will do the unexplained first and then the peace kiss. Peace kiss. How are you doing, Hoju? Send you the video. Wait. Hey, Google, how much is left on timer? Chicken is already looking amazing. I may have to cover it later on. First, the unexplained. Back from my pseudo family holiday visit. Oh, you already had your holiday visit? Nice. Nice. Okay, do we want to learn about, let's see. Paranormal phenomena? Yeah. Do you want to hear about moving coffins or stopped clocks? Let me know. Why did you send me them? I love the socials. Gotta be coffin. That's true. That's okay. Okay. Let's see. Okay. You ready? Moving objects, page 40. Some experts claim that objects made of metal and wood respond to powerful energies such as the presence of a ghost or spirit, or even a negative energy left behind following a violent death or accident. When these objects respond to external energies, which can be imprinted on a location or on the item itself, they move or appear to be animate. When circumstances mimic the original distressing situation, the objects respond in kind. This is much the same theory as the event reenactment, whereby a profound energy is imprinted on an area, causing events to rerun. Frederick Myers believed that some form of consciousness survives death and is capable of telepathically projecting images, including those of material objects, to the living. These are then perceived as phantoms. Hey, goedenavond. Okay. Moving coffins. It may not seem surprising that coffins are the focus of spiritual activity. Interestingly, however, the majority of coffin-related hauntings do not take place in cemeteries. Most cases of moving coffins occur in sealed vaults, which, when opened, reveal the coffins in disarray. One explanation is that water seeps into or floods the vaults, causing the coffins to float and then warp. This cannot explain movements in hermetically sealed or watertight vaults. However, these remain a mystery. The Barbados mystery. Okay, you are ready? In Barbados, I'm going to show you the picture. In Barbados in 1912, a strange sequence of events occurred within a sealed tomb. A family tomb was opened to bury Colonel Thomas Chase, an affluent Englishman. The tomb had been opened 3 times previously to inter his wife and 2 daughters, and on each of these occasions, nothing was found to be amiss. However, when the tomb was opened to bury the colonel, the coffins were in disarray, as if they had been tossed in the air and allowed to fall on the ground. Anxious family members assumed that the tomb had been vandalized, although there was no exterior evidence of this, and the coffins were duly rearranged and the tomb tightly sealed once more. Over the following 8 years, whenever the tomb was opened, it was found in disorder. Finally, in 1820, the governor of Barbados ordered the tomb to be unsealed. He found that sand laid on the floor of the tomb was undisturbed, yet the coffins were again in totally different positions around the tomb. One of the coffins appeared to have been thrown against the wall with such force that a deep gash was left in the stone. This prompted the family to remove all the coffins and bury them elsewhere, where they remain untouched. Paranormal scientists believe that poltergeists or restless spirits are responsible for coffins shifting. The majority of cases seem to occur when the dead died by their own hand, or were victims of a violent or unexpected death. Dum dum dum! Crazy, right? I mean, moving coffins? I mean... Do you believe it, guys? Do you believe that it was a force beyond? Okay. Chicken is doing good. We're gonna add the potatoes to the oven. Potato stacks. Hey Google, set timer for 20 minutes called potato.
Second timer, potato.
It's not your tarot retreat. Okay, I will now do your turn. Potato dance! Cannibals. Oh, I knew it was X. How am I doing today? I'm doing good, thank you. How are you doing? I'm feeling more and more festive, so that's a good thing. Potato, potato. Tomato, tomato. Oh, thank you for the follow, Flings the Jinx. I didn't see that. Okay, I am going to read the weekly tarot reading of Ho Terrific. It's Pisces or Piscis. It might still be the one of this week. Oh, it's this. You want to hear this week or next week, Hoju? Them taters be in the oven. I repeat, the taters are in the oven. Is that a potato, a pirate potato in an ice cube? You don't say. Next week, okay. Let's see what the future holds. Terrific, your Pisces tarot reading of next week. The card is Judgment. Week of Monday, December 26th. You could be on the verge of decisions that will have a long-lasting impact, Ho Terrific. You've been at this crossroads for a while, unsure of which path to go down. The Judgment card knows the best choices come from the perfect blending of head and heart. This will require you to look to your past for tangible lessons you've learned, but you must also connect with your inner self and listen to what your intuition is trying to tell you. This is the week to make your decision, and you already have everything you need to do so. Hello, hello, this is Nighthawk. The N is in the enhance. And I repeat, the N is in the enhance. Wait. I didn't see it, I think. It's another... I'm not getting it. What do you think of the reading? I wonder. So now we're going to make the apple with the cranberry sauce. Not sure if you all are familiar with this. If you aren't, it's very tasty. You need apple, of course, a little bit of lemon juice. There. A little bit of sugar or maple syrup or honey, you can choose. And cranberry sauce, I'm scared, but does it make sense or not really? You have the decision is in your hands, you know? You get to decide. Hi, Dorit! How are you doing, lovely friend? How is life going? Are you already Christmas prepping? Someone asked a question earlier. If this is all food that I'm going to be eating today, or if this is already Christmas prepping. This is all food for today and tomorrow. We have to make a Christmas ham that we will be prepping on Saturday because we need it on Sunday. And I might also stream that. I'm not sure yet. go. How are you doing, Darth? Are you already Christmas prepping? Doing well. Finish work. Ooh, 4 days off. Yes. I like that. Welcome to the kitchen. Currently, we are making apples with cranberry sauce. We're making a Christmas dinner on a budget. There you go. So first you have to peel the apple. And then you have to core it. If you have a core gadget, you can use that. I don't have one. That's one of the gadgets that I do not own yet, probably. But I'm going to try and get it out like this. I'm just going to stab the apple. Not really in a celebration mood, don't know why. Didn't even put up my Christmas tree. Oh, Hecke. That's okay. It's okay to not feel in the Christmas mood. We also didn't put up the Christmas tree. Are you going to spend time with family or loved ones? Sometimes I do honestly feel like Christmas is overrated because you should just celebrate family time all year round if you can. It's just, I think Christmas time is just a way that everyone gets a day off, so everyone has more time to get together with the family. Like my peeler, it's from OXO. It even has a little thingy, a spoon thingy to take out the bad pieces. I also have a peeler from Joseph Joseph, that's also a very good one. But price, quality wise, this one is a very good one. You didn't put up a tree either? You know, I hate shopping for certain kitchen tools. I have hung up the Christmas lights. I like that. That's good. And I have like a wreath kind of thing there. I like that one too. It's very comfy. That's true. But it's also always so much food. And you have to eat it because probably in every country or culture, if you don't eat all the food, they'd be like, but I put so much effort into making the food and now you're not eating it. Is it not tasty? And then you're like, of course it's tasty. It's just so much food on so... like so little days. Every day is so much food. And then you eat the food and then you gain a lot of weight. And then your New Year resolution can be, hey, let's lose some weight. Is the OXO Good Grips one? I mean, it has like this soft thingy, so you can just hold it like that. It's nice. I like it. It feels good in the hand. It's easy to clean. Decorations are irrelevant. That's true, Lara. I'm looking forward to seeing you and Ben tomorrow on the Christmas family stream. Now I'm going to fill the bowl with water. And a little bit of lemon juice. And then we can let the apples soak in. That's better. You are the tree. Wait, what? Just stick to electric can openers. Electric can openers? Is that a thing? This will, the lemon juice will help with the apples not turning brown. Is that a thing in your country? Apples with cranberry juice sauce? Hi, Night Parsival. Hello. Good evening to you. Cheers. Happy Thursday before Christmas. Price quality wise, I prefer this one. But Joseph has nicer colors. But I do really like this one. I have this from Amazon. You are the tree. Just put some ornaments in your winter plants. Bob, bob. Very nice. We have apples filled with marzipan, chocolate, raisins, and nuts.
Interesting.
Interesting. The chicken is getting a very nice color already. So that's for the apples. I'm going to get an oven dish and roll a quick B-roll. Be right back. Daily vegan. Ooh, it's like a mini apple cake. It's, wow, it's an apple strudel in an apple. I like. I would definitely try that. Mm-hmm. Okay, I have my little cute oven dish here. I'm going to spray it with some baking spray. Yeah, it does look very good. Very tasty. Did the apples are going in. And on here, we're going to add the cranberry sauce. Actually, I feel the same about raisins. Sai, it's like, it's not the same. Cooked raisin, they absorb a lot of moisture and they just don't taste the same. Okay, I need something to push it in. Voila. Oop. You just push it in. Shh, Sai. Think about your New Year resolution. Oh yeah, it's still not the New Year. How long will you keep it up? Did your parents send you a Christmas gift, Sai? There you go.
I'm an adult.
Who said that you were
an adult?
0 days, 0 hours, 0 minutes, and 1 second. Nice. Oh, Smo. Hi there. How are you doing? They didn't get you a birthday gift either. Now we're going to sprinkle some sugar over. Voila. And this is now going into the oven. It doesn't need a very long time. Just a teensy tiny thing. I'm going to check the temperature on the chicken. The apple is not on the, because I couldn't find like an English. We're at 60 degrees Celsius. This is going in. Hey Google, set timer for 7 minutes.
Third timer for 7 minutes. And that's starting now.
Woohoo! You guys like cranberry sauce? Doing great. We'll bake. Oh! What is your baked apple going to be like? Oh, cookie bits. Cookie gave some pitties. I'm going to bake it red. The gifts that keeps on giving. If you put your hair in the ribbon, Sai, you can be the gift. There you go. Now, it will be prepared similarly to the description of pittets. This is just cranberries. Oh, with the yeah, cool. What was I gonna get? Oh yeah. I have to do something real quick.
Your potato timer is up.
To see how the one with the cranberry tastes. I'm going to put on some walnuts as well. But that's for when they're baked. If only you weren't so far away, I'd help contribute this weird goal. Wait, what goal? What goal are we talking about? My potatoes, they have gone its own way, so I'm going to get them back together and I'm going to pop them on top. It's like what you do with the freshly baked cookies when they're right out of the oven and you want to give the cookies the nice round shape again. You put a circle over them and you make them round again. So now these are going back on top. Hey Google, set timer for 3 minutes called potato. Potato, 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 potato. Boil them, mash them, stick them in a stick. Yes. That. Exactly that. Assemble the group. It's turtle time. Does your fridge not have a light? Yes. It does have a light. It's just needs to be fixed. We're looking for a new fridge for the house. Does anyone have any good brands or fridges that they feel like are very good?
That's to be black.
Yeah. The fridge is in dark mode. So for this budget friendly, beans wrapped in bacon, I went for frozen beans because I looked it up and frozen beans are, let's say, 2 to 3 euros cheaper per kilo than fresh beans. And they look very good. Ta-da! And that's basically it. That's all you have to do. You grab a sheet of bacon. You get a stack of beans. Do you mind, bean? It's also no biggie if your beans are not the same size, because it will make it rustic. And then you roll it up. Bacon, 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 bacon. Talking about bacon, bacon. You speak salty cured meat too? I'm in the opposite boat. I can easily eat all the things and very much need not to. Wait, what? I'm too small to eat all the things I want to bake. There is no problem here eating all the things I bake.
Your potato timer is up.
Potato! Stop! Look at this crispy stack of potatoes. How good do they look? How good do they look? So, if you do it like this, then you can stack them together again. See? It's perfect. I'm gonna let them hang right there. The apples. I think the apples can go for a little bit longer. Hey Google, how much is left on timer?
T-minus 19 minutes and 47 seconds.
We'll let the bacon, we'll let the apple do its thing. Last thing I made was a whole sheet of baklava. Do need to make baklava again. So good. Baklava. Wrap the stack of beans. Hopla. Perfect. Thank you. Get a stopwatch and watch a pro. Wait. Fire department and food banks get my bulk, and neighbors get the random goodies. I like that idea. Me too. Trick is baking stuff. I've seen so much baklava. I've really been inconsidering giving a whirl. There is a difference between Greek baklava and Turkish baklava. Does anyone know what the difference is?
I hope so, King T-Dot.
Did you get Vincent his PS5 for Christmas? We'll see. We'll see if he will get it, if he's nice or naughty. To get the PS5. But he's been putting all of his hopes for that gift. So if it's not going to be the PS5, I don't know what's gonna happen.
Divorce.
We're not even married.
Future divorce.
And Persian baklava. A lot of variations in baklava, yeah. Are you impish or admirable? What? Hand of trader recipes? This is my life, Karmic Bob.
Oh.
He's a spoiled brat.
I'm not spoiled.
No, that's true. You work very hard for the stuff you buy. That's true. He likes goodies, but he works very hard to be able to afford them. And then I feel if you work hard, you deserve to get them. That's my opinion. An office reference. So So if Vincent is divorcing Clara, does that mean I can take Clara for myself? Oh, there is a plot twist. I thought you were gonna say I can take Vincent for myself, but you meant me. I feel very flattered. Did you get on the board? Uh-oh. When did you sub, Lara? Did I miss it? Let me see if you got on the board. You're not on the board! Tell me. Oh yeah, we're already engaged. Guys, I have black chocolate salted caramel ice. Any ideas to turn it into a proper dessert? Maybe a white chocolate. Did we? Hand of traded recipes are some of the best, yes. I will pick your colors. Pick your colors, Lara. I will put you on there. Okay, Peter, the black chocolate and salted caramel ice, is that like one all in the ice cream, or? Because I think you could do a white chocolate sauce, but I feel like you need something crispy to go with it as well. You could turn it into an affogato. No, you pick your colors. I'll put you on the tree. Around it, affogato. Or like a cookie base. Like something crumbly. Oh, you know what? Maybe some biscotti. Affogato, that's like an espresso shot with ice cream. So you have your bowl of ice cream and then you pour some espresso over it. You can make it with the mocha pot or with your coffee maker. Orange? No, maybe some biscotti. What other color do I need to... Oh, orange as a color. I thought orange with the ice cream. Decided to brew an interesting decaf for my afternoon cup. What are the flavor notes? Guinness beer. Ice cream with Guinness beer, like a floating thing. Choco ice cream. Like a stout. Melt chocolate and pour on ice cream. Yes. Orange and green? No, not green because the tree is green. Orange and blue? I'm gonna do it. You can hang above Sahi. Is that okay, Lara? There you go. I have a question. Why are we not just eating the ice cream on its own? It's not fancy enough. You have to make it a bit more fancy. Sai? As for these apples with cranberry sauce, I'm going to chop up some walnuts and we're going to put it on top. Are you hungry already, Vincent? Me neither. We ate so much this afternoon. We had a very late lunch. B- because something very weird happened. It was so sad. We were, we went to pick up Vincent's brother, Thomas, and his girlfriend, Kaisa, which we all know. And we went to Vincent's mom to drop them off. And they have two dogs. And one of them is a French bulldog. And suddenly he started acting super weird. Like, his legs would get stiff and he would get like a lot of saliva and his eyes would just stare. So he was actually having an epileptic attack. It was so scary. So Vincent and Thomas, they rushed to the vet, and then the vet immediately could say that it was an epileptic attack. So he's on medication now, but it was super scary. And apparently it was because it was like he was too excited. And when dogs, when they get like a genetic epileptic seizures, it will happen when they turn 3 years old. And he's now 3 years old. Yeah, it was very scary. We're still talking about a mouse died. Wait, what? What is a Viennetta? Oh, we have that every year. It's very heavy on the stomach because you ate so much already, and then you have the Viennetta. Crazy. I don't know. He's okay now, but it was just very scary. Around what time are you streaming tomorrow? I remember the commercials. Gonna check on the chicken. Guys, we're doing an amazing job. We are 2.5 hours in, and I have like almost everything ready already.
Ready already.
It's crazy. The green beans and the bacon are doing its thing. The chicken is also doing its thing. I'm gonna check the temperature to see if it reached the desired temperature. Yep. Guys, we're there. The chicken is ready. Are you ready? I mean, look at the juices. Look at the chicken.
Nice.
We're going to cover it with some aluminium foil and let it rest for 20 minutes. Hey Google, cancel chicken timer.
No problem. The one called chicken canceled.
Hey Google. Set timer for 20 minutes called chicken. So now we have to let it rest for 20 minutes. So that the juices will get back to its place. There you go. And then we can cut it, and we'll have an amazing chicken.
Chicken!
Hi, cheese, please! How are you doing? It's chicken time! Oh, well, thank you for the lurk, friend. Well, let me still tell you what we're doing. I already have my potato sticks. They are here. I have my baked apple with cranberry sauce and a bit of sugar around and walnuts. I have my chicken. Her name is Latest Chicken. The bacon and green beans are in the oven, and now we're going to make the appetizer. And the appetizer is a candy cane shaped mozzarella and tomato. There. It's gonna be nice. Let me clean this up. How are you doing? What are your plans for Christmas dinner? Eat the nummy latest chicken. Get the chicken out of the wood fire, please. Yes, it has been roasting long enough now. But I'm thinking what kind of plate. We need tomatoes. We need mozzarella. We need basil. I have some basil in a cup. You don't like the tomato? Nuggets? Ooh, what you having with the nuggets? Chicken time for Shahi. I'm doing okay, thank you. Legend of 1900. Kind of finishing things up for the holidays, doing a quick drive to the suburbs for dinner. End the day on Christmas. Ooh. Your dinner party has been nice. Yes. Thank you. I'm thinking. Oh yeah. And balsamic vinegar. Hi Sfeerbeheer. Hoe gaat het? Goeie avond. Welcome to my budget-friendly Christmas dinner, where we're having roasted chicken, apples with cranberry sauce, stacked potatoes, frozen green beans wrapped in bacon, and tomato and mozzarella appetizer. How are you doing? What are your plans for this Christmas weekend? Hi, Snooze! Been a while since I really looked. I remember hearing bad things about and looking at the Ranchillo Silvia. Wait, what are we talking about? Are we talking about the cheese or coffee? And deadline days and nights. It's like Twitch laat u blijft like die long to like. Hey Sfeer, heb je het einde van mijn kerstkoekjes gezien? My plans are eating, opening presents, eating, drinking, taking a nap in between eating. Frozen green beans, they taste as good though. Just saying. I need dinner appetizer ideas because that's what I have to make. Ooh, okay, so cheese. Have you seen my newest Instagram reel with the... Wait, let me share it. I think you saw it. With the pull apart pizza bread? No, niet gezien. Ah, wacht, ja. Here. The finished ugly Christmas sweater cookies. I already ate a few and this one turned into a t-shirt. But still, look. I'm legit proud of this one. You can have I love pizza one. This is my favorite, so I don't want to eat it. What was vandaag? Nee, was gisteren. All of them are super, like my tie-dye t-shirt. Oh my god. And if you put your arms up of the sweater, then you have a Christmas wreath, you see? Never eat them. Okay, I will spray hair, how do you say it? Hard luck. Hairspray on them, so they keep good. Okay, I'm gonna show you my end of the year appetizer. Oh, another thing that I think might be nice. Here you have like puff pastry mini pizzas. And you can also make it with cream cheese, spinach and salmon, which is also nice. Or with cheese and pepperoni, which is also nice. That's a good appetizer. And this. Like my dance. It's like, it's how you have to feel when watching the video. Ta-da! That was it. Is that an appetizer you could get? Like, it's the nicest one. Oh, thank you. It's blood, sweat, and tears. Fair. Blood, sweat, and tears. Or, oh my god, cheese, please. Oh my god. What if you make... Okay, I'm gonna show one more. What if you make... tomato confit that they can just put on their toast. Oh. I mean, yes. That would be the best appetizer.
I'll never forget the moment we kissed the night of the hayride. The way that we hugged to try to keep warm.
What if?
In the sleigh ride,
you do everything. Hi, Billy Blaze.
Memories we've been shared.
Okay, dokey. Sphere. Crush that up your deadline. We're gonna do a party moment just for you. And you have to dance. And you have to give it your all. And then you can give it your all for the deadline, okay? Everyone ready for the party? Everyone? Max, you ready? Pierre, you ready? Laura? Billy Blaze? Cheese? You ready? Okay. Okay, now do it. Go do your thing. Go, go crush it. Everyone, all the regulars know what's up. And she'd be like, what's happening? Yes, this is what you get. Do I have it? Oh, I don't have it anymore. Just do it! I don't have it anymore. Thank you for partying. Calum Hito! Okay, I do know that reference. Wow. Yerisa. Hi, Beast. How are you doing?
How are you doing, friend?
Ooh, my beans are done. More than done. They are done, done. They are
done, done, done.
Sorry. It's the coffee. I think the coffee is finally kicking in. Hey, your back is on fire. You hear the sizzle? Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. You know what? If I do this, okay. Now in all seriousness, we're gonna make this. Bye. Yeah, bye. See ya later. We're gonna use this plate. This will be nice. Or I'm going to go for the wooden one. Why are chefs so harsh?
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
They're always beating eggs. Okay. That deserves one. Oh yeah, wait. I own a Breville Infuser Pro and in Como I have a Rocket Espresso Art Appartamento. Very nice. Indubitably Brandon, thank you so much for the raid. Welcome to the kitchen. How was your stream? Welcome in. What did you do? Did you also do some Christmas cooking? I'm sorry, I had coffee. I'm very, very much awake. How was your stream? Thank you for doing the shout out. We are now about to make. Hello?
Cafe and Linux gifted a tier 1 sub to Indubitably Brendan.
Indubitably Brendan. Thank you so much for the gifts of Linux. You're too kind. What color would you like? Do some crosswords to start off the day and prep for some festivities tomorrow. Nice. Cookie! You want to make me eat hot sauce again? Okay. Thank you for the bits. What color would you like, Cookie? Thank you so much. Christmas colors, that's green and red, right? Or red and yellow. If you're Gryffindor. Blue! Nice pick. Love the festive vibes today. This morning I wasn't really into the Christmas vibe, but now I'm getting into the Christmas vibes. I like this. I like where this is going. Pick something from the wheel, friend. Cookie. RMC. And Twitch does help, especially my community. I love my community. And I assume they like me too. Thank you, Linux. The Breville Infuser might be more realistic to go. It's a good one. It's, I think, price quality range, that's a good one. Actually, Cookie, can't you? Oh, chubby bunny. Okay. I still have to find. Okay. Okay, here is the deal. We're going to. It must be in this mess somewhere. Oh. Can we all give a hug to Snooze? And then we're gonna sing a Christmas song. And then we're gonna do Chubby Bunny. And then the Christmas spirit will come out of this firewood oven. Okay? Okay? We will help everyone find that Christmas cheer. It's a hard train! Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo train rolling down. I'm in the firewood train. I can hear your whistle blowing loud.
An anonymous user gifted a T1 sub to your account.
Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo train rolling down the choo-choo rails. I can hear your whistle blowing loud. Choo-choo. You rock girl. Hype in the chat if you wanna join. Let's jump on the hype train, come on, let's go. Thank you for the biddies and thank you for the subs. Thank you for the never-ending love. Let's go! Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo train rolling down the choo-choo rails. I can hear your whistle blowing loud. Choo-choo-choo-choo-choo-choo train rolling down the choo-choo rails. I can hear your whistle blowing loud, choo-choo. Thank you so much, Linux, for the gift sub. And thank you, Cookie, for the beady beadies. Thank you, Ghosty, for the sip gift. Thank you, Ghosty, for another two, you rock girl. Thank you for the never-ending love. Choo 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 train rolling down the choo choo rails. I can hear your whistle blowing loud. Choo 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 train rolling down the choo choo rails. I can hear your whistle blowing loud. Thank you so much for starting the hype train, guys. We're almost onto level 2. Thank you. I feel like those are all Christmas presents, so thank you so much. Ghosty will get. Can you believe I'm tired from singing this song? Ghosty will get some more sparkles around the ghosty. Why, thank you for the fart, Snooze. What color do you want? Because you're going in the package. In the gift. And Cookie chose blue. Linux, did you pick a color already? Gifts. La Pavoni. Oh, you want to see?
Your chicken timer is up.
Stop. Blue, stop. Hi, Barnes Emma. Hello. Welcome in. I haven't tried the La Pavoni again. Because I didn't have time for it and I really wanted to take all of my time to make it work very well and not break it. So, But I will take my time for it. If I think probably when we move to the house. Imagine if Pink Floyd used those sounds for Dark Side of the Moon. Imagine.
I came for the potato stacks and stayed for the dance party.
Hey, Max! I came for the potato stacks and stayed for the dance party. Yay! Thank you so much. You're going in my Christmas tree. What color would you like? Linux wanted it blue. I want to paint it blue. What is going in the pack? Yes. I will wrap you all up. Of course. Twitch purple. Yes. Whoa, guys. Thank you so much for the hype train. Claps for you. Thank you so much. Blue light now. Max is going to turn into a balloon. Max. Thank you for the sub. Okay, do we agree on the Christmas song to be? Have a Jolly Christmas? Or do we have other song recommendations? Let me know. As I will clean just a little bit. An Hawaiian song for Christmas? Is there an Hawaiian song for Christmas? Sure. Sahibi Agi, yeah, sing whatever. Malakaleki Maka. And you want me to sing that? Oh, wow. Okay, it really is a Christmas song. Wait.
Where palm trees sway, here we know that Christmas will be green and bright. The sun to shine by day and all the stars at night. Melikilikimaka is a wise way to say Merry Christmas to you.
Oh my god, this song. Oh, I don't know it though, but it's fun. Michael Bublé. Okay.